Welcome to the roof segment for the Chief Architect Bachelor View project. In this video, I'll cover the automatic roof options, look at setting the wall properties to control the roof, and then look at how to curve this particular roof. Let's begin by looking at the automatic roof tool options. In our previous seminar, we left off with a floor plan and our dimensions placed. When you start with the roof, I like to always change my save plan view into the roof plan view. This will also change the layer set and turn on the roof planes when we then build them. Let's go ahead and take a 3D overview using the perspective floor overview camera. This camera will then display the roof when it's built and show you the ceiling as well. Let's explore the Build Roof dialog and then start with the automatic roof. Underneath the Build menu, you'll find the option for building the automatic roof. Now there are a variety of roof styles that you can build within the program. If you go down to the bottom of this panel and look at the roof styles, each one of these different styles you can click on and it will show you step by step how to change these roofs and create them. Typically you're going to be changing the roofs by setting the wall properties underneath of that wall. As an example, when you create a gable roof, you're typically going to select the wall, toggle it to a gable, and it will automatically generate the wall underneath the correct style of a roof. On the main roof panel, let's begin by turning on our automatic roofs, my default 8 and 12 pitch roof, and let's take a look at it. The default roof that's built is just an 8 and 12 pitched hip roof. Let's go back in to that automatic roof and let's change the pitch to 2 and 12 and begin from this point forward. Now I'm going to begin on the side of the house over here where the master bath is. I'm just going to tap on the wall. I'm going to toggle that to a full gable. Since the automatic roof is on, it will change the roof for you. On the back section here where the master will overlook the slope and the swimming pool, I'm going to click on the sidewall, rotate around, click on the other sidewall, holding my shift key down, make the same change to switch these to gable walls, and then on the back wall, I'm going to switch this to a shed ceiling. I don't have a shortcut on my edit toolbar down here, but if you click on the open on the roof panel for the wall, you can see all of the different options you can change for the walls. For this particular wall, we'll just set it to be a high shed gable wall. All right, let's walk our way around the front of the house, make a simple change here, toggle that to a full gable. That's where the office will be located. And then on this section, we'll come back to that. I want to change this section through here to also be a shed that will slope from the lower wall on your screen to the upper wall. I'm also going to change the pitch to a 3 and 12 for that segment of the roof. Let's come around to the garage section. I'm going to change this wall, again hold my shift key down, this wall to be a full gable. We'll toggle that on. And then on this section right back here, I also want to add a little bit of variety and make this a gable wall. Let's go back into our floor plan and look at the option to do that. In this split screen view with floor plan on the left, one of the tools that you have access to is a roof gable line. And you can come in here and simply drag out a line and create that gable. I'm going to go ahead and click undo, and I'm going to show you one way that's a little bit faster and a little more precise, because then I don't have to exactly line that gable up with the other side. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to use this wall tool temporarily and extend it down. Now I know exactly where that intersection needs to be on this wall. I'm going to use the break tool. I'm going to create a break right in that intersection right here, and on this segment of the wall, I can now toggle that to be a gable roof. And now I can simply pull that existing wall back, snap that into place, and that just served as a temporary way to use the wall tools to automatically generate the roof, and I know it's symmetrical with the other side. Now for this section of the roof right in here, I want to create a shed that will extend all the way up. Let's just see if we can do this in 3D. What I'm going to do to begin with is take the back wall and then the front wall, hold my shift key down, toggle those to full gable walls. And now on the side walls, we'll go ahead and select the side walls. By the way, to remain in selection mode, I'm going to hold my Alt key down and my middle mouse button and orbit around. I'm still in selection mode. You can see that wall selected. Hold my Shift key down, click on the other wall, and now I can use the open button and then make the change for a high shed gable wall. Now that's going to leave that at a 2-12 pitch, and what I want to try out is I want to see what this is going to look like at a steeper pitch, and I want to try it at 3-12. To do that, I'm going to grab the two opposing walls, again hold my shift key down, use the open button, and then come into the roof section and change the pitch. Again, the automatic roofs are still on, and it will observe the change with those wall properties and automatically make the shift for you, completely using the automatic roof tools. Now, there are manual roof tools in the program. You can use those tools to create a variety of different roof styles. And one of the things that I did want to look at with this particular design is, what would it look like if it were curved? Maybe the client asks you to give you a few different roof options. Here's what I'm going to do to curve this roof. Tap on the roof plane, double click to open it up. You'll notice all of the settings that you can manually override this as you go in here and make changes. The diagram will update. If you're using trusses, it will also update on how you're doing that. What I'm really after is to curve this roof, and I'm going to go ahead and set the angle at the ridge to 0 degrees. And then let's take a look. The program is going to let you know that it will be turning off the automatic roofs when you go into manual mode, and let's go ahead and accept that. And now you can see what's happened with that curved roof. Now there are join tools that you can use that will automatically join the curved roof to other roofs or other roofs to any other roof. And you can do that by selecting the roof. Notice right near my cursor is a red indicator. That means that selected edge is active. There's a tool that you'll find in the lower edit menu to join roof planes. It's also a number 2 shortcut on your keyboard. You may notice that from the pop-up on the tool. And when you click on this tool, I can come over, click on this edge, and you'll see that it automatically joined that. You can do the same thing over here. See the selected edge. Press number 2 on the keyboard. Click on this edge. And you can see the way that it has curved and changed that roof. And now you can visually show your client what the difference is between the different roof styles. Maybe you're changing it, as we began with an 8-12 pitch, change it to 6, 4, 2, which is what the majority of this roof is. And it's a great way to be able to visually show this. As far as how to frame your roof, there is a stick framing option that I typically will show, as you can see here on the screen. Many times you're going to be sending your floor plan off to the truss company. They will engineer it. Chief Architect does have trusses in the program. If you need to show a section or if you need to truss the entire diagram, you can. Now typically I will draw my roofs and get this dialed in before I draw my interior walls, because I want to make sure that the roof is going to work for the floor plan before I invest a lot of time in drawing all of the interior walls and then building the foundation. And I'm at the point now where this roof looks pretty good. I will undo that curved portion of the roof and leave that as a shed. And then in the next section, I'll move on and take a look at the foundation.